चैप्टर वर्क एनर्जी एंड पावर। इन आवर डेली लाइफ वी फ्रीक्वेंटली यूज दिस वर्ड्स वर्क एनर्जी एंड पावर। वी विल डिस्कस लैटर क्लियरली। लेट अस स्टार्ट विथ स्केलर प्रोडक्ट। आर डॉट प्रोडक्ट सो द स्केलर आर डॉट प्रोडक्ट बिटवीन एनी टू वेक्टर इज इक्वल टू द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ द बोथ वेक्टर्स एंड द कोसाइन ऑफ द एंगल बिटवीन देम। सपोज आई एम टेकिंग टू वेक्टर्स ए बार एंड डी बार। So here dot product or scalar product of two vector a bar dot b bar is equal. So how we can define the product of their magnitudes? So here magnitude of a bar is a, magnitude of b bar is b, and cosine of angle between them, here the angle between a bar and b bar is theta, cosine of cos theta. So here finally a bar dot b bar is equal a b cos theta. So here the result of a bar dot b bar is a scalar. A is nothing but the magnitude of a bar, b is nothing but magnitude of b bar, cos theta, theta is the angle between a bar and b bar. So it is a scalar. The result of a bar dot b bar is a scalar. Here we use dot, so it is a dot product. So finally a bar dot b bar is equal ab cos theta. So how we can define the product of their magnitudes and cosine of angle between them is known as scalar product. So here a bar dot b bar is also written as, so here a bar dot b bar is also written as a into b cos theta, that is equal b into a cos theta. Geometrically here b cos theta is the projection of b bar on a bar. Here a cos theta is the projection of a bar on b bar. So here b cos theta is b cos theta is the projection of b bar on a bar. Here a cos theta is the projection of a bar on b bar. So if I am taking two vectors, so it is a bar, this one is b bar, the angle between two vector is theta. So here it is a bar, here it is b bar. So here angle between theta is 0. So here this is projection of b bar on a bar. So this is known as b cos theta. So here b cos theta is projection of b bar on a bar. Similarly it is a bar, if it is b bar, so the angle between two vector is theta. So this one, so here it is a cos theta. So here A cos theta is, A cos theta is projection of A bar, projection of A bar on B bar. So how we can define the scalar product of two vector A bar dot B bar. So here A bar dot B bar is here A into B cos theta. So we know here B cos theta, if I am resolving B bar into two component. So for example it is x axis, for example it is y axis. So if I am resolving B bar into two component along x axis, along y axis. So here along x axis the component of B bar is B cos theta. So here the component of B bar is B cos theta is in the direction of A bar. So we can define, how we can define A bar dot B bar is equal the product of magnitude of A bar, the product of magnitude of A bar and the component of B bar, the component of B bar along A bar direction. So here A bar dot B bar is the scalar product of A bar and B bar is the product of magnitude A bar, magnitude of A bar and the component of B bar along A bar direction. The component of B bar along A bar direction. Similarly, here A bar dot B bar is equal, A bar dot B bar is equal B into A cos theta. So if I am resolving A bar, I am resolving A bar into two components. So suppose I am taking this x axis, it is y axis. So the x component is, here it is y component. So the component of A bar along y axis, so theta is this side, here theta is this side. So this component is A cos theta. So the component of A bar along y axis is A cos theta. So the component of A bar along B axis, B direction. So here B is in the direction of, B is in the direction of y axis. So the component of A bar, the component of A bar along B axis, B along B bar is A cos theta. So how we can define A bar dot B bar, the scalar product of A bar dot B bar is the magnitude of B bar, the magnitude of B bar. So the product of magnitude of B bar and the component of A bar along B bar direction, the component of A bar along B direction. The scalar product follows the commutative law. The scalar product follows commutative law. So here A bar dot B bar is equal B bar dot A bar. So here A bar dot B bar is equal A B cos theta. It can be written as B A cos theta, that is equal B bar dot A bar. So the scalar product obey commutative law. Scalar product obey distributive law. So your scalar product follows distributive law. Here A bar dot B bar plus C bar is equal, I can write A bar dot B bar plus A bar dot C bar. So the scalar product obey distributive law. If lambda is a constant, if lambda is a real number, so I can write A bar dot lambda into B bar if lambda is a real number. So if we take outside, I can take lambda. Lambda is not a vector, it is a scalar. So simply I am take outside. So it can be written as a bar dot lambda into b bar is written as a bar lambda into a bar dot b bar. For unit vectors I j k bar, I cap j cap k cap, we have here I cap is unit vector along x axis, j cap is unit vector along y axis, k cap is unit vector along z axis. So here unit vectors means it have the magnitude of this vector is 1. So we have i cap dot i cap is equal j cap dot j cap is equal k cap dot k cap is equal 1. i dot j cap is equal i cap dot j cap is equal j cap dot k cap is equal k cap dot i cap is equal 0, because here i cap dot i cap. So here dot product, the magnitude of I cap is 1, the magnitude of I cap is 1. So cos, both are I cap is parallel to I cap, so the angle between I cap and I cap is 0 degrees. So finally it is 1 1. Cos 0, it is also 1. So here I dot I is equal 1. Similarly j dot j is equal 1, k dot k cap dot k cap is equal 1. For example, I am taking i cap dot j cap. So here I cap, the magnitude of I cap is 1, the magnitude of j cap is 1, but the angle between I cap and j cap is, here it is I cap and j cap is 90 degrees. So cos 90, here cos 90 is 0, so 1 dot 1 dot 0. So 1 into 1 into 0, it is 0. So I dot j is equal 0, j dot k is equal 0, k dot I is equal 0. Given two vectors, for example, a bar is ax I cap plus ay j cap plus az k cap, b bar is equal bx I cap plus by j cap plus bz k cap. So here what is a bar dot b bar? So here a bar ax I cap plus ay j cap plus az k cap dot bx I cap plus by j cap plus bz k cap. So here I am taking dot product. So simply I dot I is equal to 1, I dot j 0, I dot k 0. So I dot I is equal to 1. So ax into bx plus j dot I 0, j dot j 1, j dot k 0. So similarly it is ay by plus k dot I 0, k dot j 0, k dot k, it is az bz. So here the scalar product of two vector a bar dot b bar is equal, what is that? It is ax bx plus ay by plus az bz. If I am taking same vector, for example, if it is a bar dot a bar, a bar dot a bar. So here what is a bar? Ax I cap plus ay j cap plus az k cap dot. So here it is a bar. So a bar is also ax I cap plus ay j cap plus a z k cap. So here a x, what is a bar dot b bar? A x b x plus a y b y plus a z b z. Here a x is a x, but b x is a x plus here a y is a y, but here b x is b y is a y plus here a z is a z, but here b z is a z. So a z into b z, a z. So that is equal a x square plus a y square plus a z square. So here a dot a bar dot a bar is equal a square. A bar dot a is equal a square. Since so here a bar dot a bar is equal the magnitude of a bar, it is a. The magnitude of a bar, it is a. Both are same vector. So here it is a bar, here it is also a bar. So both are same vector. So they are parallel to each other. So the angle between two vector is theta, zero. So that is zero. A into a square, cos zero is 1. So it is a square. So here a bar dot a bar is got a square. So finally a is equal, how I can write? Under root of a x square plus a y square plus a z square. Second one, if theta is 90 degrees, if theta is equal 90 degrees, means what? A perpendicular to B, both are perpendicular. So what happened? A bar dot B bar is equal. So magnitude of A, magnitude of B and cos. So both are perpendicular. So means what? It is A bar and it is B bar. The angle between these two vectors are 90 degrees. The angle between these two vector is 90 degrees. So here cos 90. So A into B cos 90 is equal to 0. So here A bar dot B bar is equal to 0. So if we get A bar dot B bar is equal to 0, the two vectors are perpendicular to each other. Or if two vectors are perpendicular, we can get A bar dot B bar is equal to 0. Example problem 6.1. Find the angle between force. F bar is 3i plus 4j minus 5k units. And displacement d bar is 5i plus 4j plus 3k unit. Also find the projection of F bar on d. So here solution. So the given vectors, here F bar is given. F bar is equal 3i cap plus 4j cap minus 5k cap. Here d bar is given 5i cap plus 4j cap plus 3k cap. So we have to find the angle between them. So first we have to find the magnitude of F bar. So here F is equal to magnitude of F bar. So we have a formula. So magnitude of A is, the magnitude of A bar is under root of AX square plus AY square plus AZ square. So here F that is called magnitude of F bar, that is good. So if I am taking it is FXI, FIJ minus F plus FZK. So it is FX square. So it is FX square plus Fy square plus Fz square. So that is equal under root of 3 square 9 plus 4 square 60 plus minus 5 square. It is 25. So how much it is? So under root of, so it is 50. So next find the magnitude of d bar. So here magnitude of d bar is equal under root of dx square plus dy square plus dz square. So here dx, dx is 5, dy is 4, dz is 3. So under root of dx square 25, 5 square 25, 4 square 16 plus 3 square 9. So 16 plus 9, 25, 25 plus 25, 50. So here f is equal square root of 50, d is equal square root of 50. So we have a formula. Let us find f bar dot d bar. So f bar dot d bar. So here f bar is 3i cap plus 4j cap minus 5k cap dot d bar 5i cap plus 4j cap plus 3k cap. So here we have a formula. So here a bar dot b bar is equal ax bx plus ay by plus az bz. So from this, here it is ax, it is bx, it is ay, it is by, it is az, it is bz. So ax bx, it is 3 into 5 plus ay, 4 into by, it is also 4 plus az, it is minus 5 into bz, it is 3. So 3 5 is the 15 plus 4 4 is the 16 minus here minus 5 3 is the 15. So if this 15, this 15 is cancelled, finally f bar dot d bar is equal to 16. But we have a formula, f bar dot d bar is equal to f d cos theta. So from this we have f bar dot d bar is equal to 16. So from the f bar dot d bar is equal to 16. So that is equal to f value is root 15, root 50. So it is root 50 value. D value is root 50 into cos theta. So from this cos theta is equal to 16 by root 50 into root 50. It is called 50. So therefore cos 60 is equal to 16 by 50. From this theta is equal to cos inverse 16 by 50. Next one, the projection of f bar. Projection of f bar on d bar is, so here the projection of f bar on d bar is f cos theta. So we know f value, so it is how much? It is root 50. So cos theta, it is how much? It is 16 by 50. So finally that is equal to 16 by, so here root 50, root 50, here we can write 50 is root 50 into root 50. So 1 root 50, 1 root 50 cancel, remaining, so 16 by root 50.